In this video, I'm going to be milling an angle bracket out of aluminum on my modified Openbuilds Minimill. This is showing what the angle bracket is. It's fairly small. This is about 3/4 inch on a side, and it's got 2 through holes for bolts and then a countersink for bolts. This is what my Minimill looks like when I did this milling. It is sitting on a big block of aluminum, and it has upgraded X, Y, and Z linear rails. So the first thing I'm doing here is just getting the stock cleaned up. When I cut the stock, I just cut it with a portable bandsaw because I didn't have my horizontal bandsaw yet. And it's really hard to cut that thing straight, so the saw ended up cutting it at an angle. And so I need to actually square it up and remove that extra material so that it's the correct size. I'm aiming for a 1-inch cubed piece of aluminum. And these are the cutting parameters for the sort of facing down that I'm doing here. Okay, so now that I've got this cut into a 1-inch cubed piece of aluminum, the thing I'm doing now is just basically setting to zero. And the way that I do this is I have a 5/1000ths, I guess it's a feeler gauge, and I'm just moving the Z down 1/1000th at a time until I can feel it grabbing the feeler gauge. And then I know that my Z coordinate is 5/1000ths. And I do the same thing for the X and the Y axes, just measuring it when it starts to grab the feeler gauge, and then I know I'm at, in this case, since the diameter of this end mill is 1/4 inch, I know that I'm, half that plus the 5/1000ths away on that face. I just have an inexpensive drill press vise here that doesn't hold things very square. I've since gotten a better one. And then also you can see I've set it up on some machinist parallels just to get it up so that I can access more of the workpiece. These are the parameters for the most of the cuts. I do some facing cuts that are a little different, and there's a finish cut that's a little different, but for the most part, this is kind of my usual feeds and speeds that I do for most of this. So I tried a few ways to cam this, and you can see that I actually had one mistake here where there are at least two mistakes here. One is it's doing a bunch of air cutting right here for this first pass, and I just I saw that in the simulation, and I just didn't bother to solve it because it doesn't waste that much time, and it's not causing any problems. I'm sure I could fix that. The second problem is that I had the stock set to 1.1 inches in the X axis. I think just left over from a previous time I had machined this with slightly larger stock. So there's a little bit of air cutting as you see it going around to the positive X axis right about here. And then you can kind of see now like the way that I've oriented the part, and it's just going to go through cutting away to clear that the sort of outer profile of the part, and then I'll be flipping it to do the through holes and the counter bore, the countersink, I mean. And I'll be doing the same thing for the other 90 degree axis of the through hole and countersink. So I'm doing a finishing pass now. I think this is 200,000ths depth of cut and 20,000ths, 10 or 20,000ths width of cut. It ended up being, I think, a little too much. You can kind of hear as it's making a cut, especially along the y-axis, some sort of like pulsing sound, and that vibration shows up in the finish. You can see some striations in it along that axis. So that was too aggressive of a cut here, but since this is a functional part, it doesn't actually matter. Okay, so I flipped the part over now, and you can kind of see the hat that's left over where I was grabbing it in the vise when it was oriented 180 degrees differently, and I'm just cutting that hat off. I have a little 3D printed fixture thing that I'm using to be able to hold on to the part while it's flipped like that. I originally wanted to make this out of aluminum because the plastic can kind of deform a little bit as the part gets a little warm, but it was actually surprisingly complicated to figure out the cam for the little fixture thing, so I just said, hey, I'll just print it and deal with it.
Thank you.
So frustratingly, I didn't quite go quite deep enough to get that hat off. And so what I'm doing here is just running sort of my normal facing program manually with a little more Z depth to get that hat out of there. Now I'm setting the part up for milling out the through hole and the countersink. This is pretty easy in terms of work holding. Just put it in the vise on the parallels. And there's a bunch of helical ramping down into the part to cut these sort of wide cylinder shapes out of the part. So you can see that first set of holes is cut, and I'm going to be flipping the part 90 degrees and doing the same exact program. Because it's the same exact program, it'll start off doing some air cutting, which is fine. It's not a really long amount of time wasted, and then as it goes further through the part that's already been cut 90 degrees the other way, it will eventually cut the last little bottom bits of the hole. I also realized that I had the camera set up not great for this operation, since it was pointed just at the back. You can see what's going on. So, like I said, a lot of this is just going to be air cutting at first, but you can at least see a little better what that helical ramp looks like. Here's the final part. It's tough to see the finish here, but you might be able to see as I turn it around along those back flat sides, one of them has better finish than the other. And then just here's a shot of it to show the scale and to show it a little more close up what the final part looks like. This is after deburring it a little bit. And that's all.